To one and all present here, myself N. Kalpana. I am from Sri G.K. Jain High Secondary School, Roypuram. Today, for the 10th standard, I am going to explain the topic is atoms and molecules. In last video, we saw about what it is atom, what is a molecule, relative atomic mass, average atomic mass, and which is related to some other calculation also we done it. Okay, in this video we know we have to see the naming the molecules. They have given the molecules. Molecules means a combination of two atoms. Okay, so they have given the molecules. How we have to name it? First thing, we have to find whether it should be a, what kind of molecule it should be, whether it should be a homo or it should be a hetero. Homo means same atom, same element will be combined together. Hetero means two different element will be combined together. Okay, so that is a homo or hetero. And next one, atomicity. So atomicity is nothing else, mono, di, tri, more than three, it should be name it as poly. Two thing we have to keep it in your mind before naming itself. For example, let's see, O2. So it should be a molecule, two oxygen atom combined together. So it should be a homo, only the oxygen will be present in it. So homo. And next, how many element? Two. So di, how many atoms will be present in it? Element means atoms, the same thing. Diatomic molecule, O3, ozone. So homo, only oxygen will be present, homo triatomic molecule. HCl, we have a two different, H and Cl will be there, so it should be hetero, heterogeneous. So hetero, how many elements are present, how many atoms, that means two. Hetero diatomic molecule, here it should be a P4, so phosphorus alone, so it should be homo. Next one, more than three means you should be name it as poly. So homo polyatomic molecule. Next we have to see the difference between the atoms and the molecules. Atoms, it is the smallest particle present in an element. Okay, molecules also be present, it should be also be a smallest particle, but it should be present in a compound. Atoms means present in the element, single element, and a molecule means present in the compound, more than the element. Okay, combination of the element will be called it as a compound. So both it should be a smallest particle, but it should be present in the atom, it should be present in the compound. It should be present in the element, it should be present in the compound. And next one, does not exist in a free state except the noble gas, because noble gas will be in a stable one, that is why it should be present in the free state. So except a noble gas, all the element, all the atom does not be exist in a free state, because it is always being in a combining with the other element. And next one, but the molecules, because it is already formed as a molecule, so it should be exist in a free state. Okay, whether it should be homo or a hetero, but it should be present in the exist in a free state. It should be highly reactive, the same thing, except the noble gas, because it should be a, again I'm telling, the noble gas will be having a stable configuration, so it should be having, that is why it should be called it as an inert pair. Inert pair means it should be in a not reactive with the other one. Okay, but all the other atom, other element should be highly reactive, because it is able to get into the stable position, that is why easily it should be reacted one. And next one, molecule. Molecule means already reacted. So that should be, it should be less reactive with the other element. Next one, does not have a chemical bond, because atom means atom will be there. Element, single element will be there. When you're seeing the element, only the element will be there. No bond present in it. Hydrogen means H only there. Carbon means C only there. Okay. But in a molecule, atoms in a molecule. For example, when you're seeing the HCl. When you're seeing the HCl molecule, always the chemical bonded. Here is showing atoms in a molecule held by. Here it should be atom. H is an atom, Cl is an atom. Atom in a molecule, it is held. How it is formed? Because of the chemical bond. Okay, these are all the difference between the atoms and the molecule, which is a very important question in this lesson. Okay, difference between. Okay, and next one, Avogadro's hypothesis. Let's see the Avogadro hypothesis. Equal volume of all gases. So in this hypothesis, it is applicable only for the gases. Equal volume of gases under similar condition. Similar condition means temperature, pressure and all, it should be the same one. Under the similar condition of temperature and pressure, contain equal number of moles. When you taken a two kinds of to before the, for example, if you're seeing the example, then it should be easy for you. Let's see it. H2 plus Cl2, which gives 2HCl. Okay, this is the example. How many moles of hydrogen will be in the reactant? 1 plus chlorine, 1. In the product, how many hydrochloridas form? 2. So this is the thing. This will be called it as a Avogadro's hypothesis. When it is should be, all should be in a gaseous substance only. All the equal volume of all gases under the similar condition, it should be in a similar condition, because it should be under the reaction. So it should be maintained the temperature as well as the pressure. So that is what it should be, having a similar condition containing equal number of molecules. In the reactant, 1 plus 1. So it should be obviously 2. In the product, it should be formed the 2. So obviously it should be the same number. That will be called it as a. These can be explained in terms of Avogadro's hypothesis. And next one, gram molecular mass. We already saw about the relative atomic mass, average mass. Relative atomic mass means, we see that if you have given the compound for that, how you find in the relative atomic mass? RMM. RMM means relative atomic mass. Let's see the example of relative atomic mass in the water molecule. H2O. Okay. So, 1 into H, how many hydrogen? Atomic number is 1 plus 1 into, sorry, 2 into 1, then 16. Okay, 2 hydrogen molecules are present. 2 into, atomic number of hydrogen is 1. 2 into 1 plus, how many oxygen are present? 1. 1 into, atomic mass of oxygen is 16. So here it should be 2 plus 16, totally 18. Okay, this is the way we have finding the relative atomic mass. The same we have find it in the gram molecular mass also. The only thing is, we have represented in the unit should be, if it is a relative atomic mass means mean no unit. Okay, if it is in the gram molecular mass means, we have to be write it as 18 gram. If it is expressed in terms of with the unit of gram means, it will be called it as a gram molecular mass. So in this lesson, we saw about the what it is an atom, definition for the atom, difference between the atoms as well as the molecule. Molecule is nothing else, a combination of atom will be called it as a molecule. Atom, what it is atom, what it is molecule, difference between atom and molecule. And next one, relative atomic mass, average atomic mass. Why we kept as a carbon as a standard unit? What it is standard unit? Why we kept as a carbon as a standard unit? And abundance. So the term abundance means, and you have to find the AMM, average atomic mass, RMM, relative atomic mass, and you should be know the GMM, gram molecular mass. And you have to know also Avogadro's law. So in this lesson, the only thing is, difference between is a very important one. And the numerical problems, we have expected a lot of, we have definitely we have expecting one numerical problem in this lesson. Thank you.